But before they were dodging the wind and the rain, fair-goers were trying to stay cool in dangerously hot weather out there today. Jennifer Hoff is live at the fairgrounds. Wow, what a day out there today, Jennifer.
Between the heat and the rain that battered down, it was certainly a mess for some people. And the grounds, as you mentioned, are technically open at least for the next hour. And there's quite a few people walking around, although very few vendors are still open. But the folks out here say that they did send a text to people alerting them about that severe weather. And then that heat coupled with that will no doubt impact attendance levels today. You know what else it also impacted is the record number of people who needed medical attention.
The Great Minnesota Get Together is where we sweat together too.
Right there.
A mix of heat, humidity, and humor.
No whining at the fair.
Except when you need more medicine than laughter, Bjorn Peterson is here to help.
It's a full-size bus.
The longtime doctor relying on a bus, usually reserved for major incidents, serving instead as a space for patients when the first aid stations are so full.
It's heat exhaustion, heat exhaustion, heat exhaustion all day long.
Some 540 people got sick on Saturday alone, setting a record and wearing staff here thin.
We don't have enough people to respond to all of the calls. We're trying to get to the most serious ones as quickly as we can.
From bee stings to seizures to simply trying to stay cool.
With the fan.
And freezy drinks.
On a day when weather would rule.
Does anyone have anyone on the way? Please seek shelter.
And the water we all needed would come soon enough, leaving Minnesotans to get soaked together too.
Some people look forward to this 12 days all year long. They're gonna make it, you know, come heck or high water, basically.
We also know this now, that already 400 some people in these first 4 days of this year have needed medical attention. That's 400 more people than in these four days from last year. So quite a high number here this time around. But the weather, of course, is going to cool down and things will get better. So the doctor in that story still reminding people to just know your limits, wear sensible clothing, and also beer is not a substitute for water.
Does not hydrate, unfortunately. All right. Thank you, Jennifer.